Hi, my name is Jenny LeCocq, and I'm the president of the Stoneham Community Development Corporation. In 2019, we completed one of our first small infrastructure projects with the installation of the book-shaped read bike racks behind me at the Stoneham Public Library. I thought this would be a perfect backdrop to announce the launch of our newest project, Stoneham Reads. On behalf of all of the board of directors of the Stoneham CDC, we are delighted to sponsor and support the launch of Stoneham Reads, and we look forward to building new community connections, one book at a time.
Everybody, before we begin, we have an important message. Accessibility has become a priority for Stoneham Reads. This video is available in ASL and with English and Spanish subtitles that are visible to screen readers. We'll give more access information in a little bit, but please don't be shy. All are welcome to join us on this project. Some access arrangements require advance notice, so register or email us today and let us know if any barriers are in your way.
Welcome. We are members of the Stoneham Reads Planning Committee and book group facilitators. We are pleased to have representatives from other Stoneham organizations participating as book group facilitators. We'd like to introduce ourselves.
Hi, I'm Jill Blagsvet, Planning Committee member and book group facilitator.
Hi, I'm Judy Bosquin, co-facilitator of Stoneham Reads and book group facilitator.
Hello, I'm Betty Chu Pryor. I am a Planning Committee member and book group facilitator.
Hi, I'm Deborah Delman. I'm part of Stoneham Coalition for a Safe and Healthy Community and a book group facilitator.
Thank you for joining us for the Stoneham Reads launch. My name is Jenny LeCocq. I am the president of the Stoneham Community Development Corporation. We are thrilled to support the launch of Stoneham Reads.
Hi, I'm Martha Esch. I'm a co-facilitator of Stoneham Reads and a book group facilitator.
Hi, my name is Rachel Overbeck, and I'm a librarian at the Stoneham Public Library. I'm on the planning committee, and I'm a book group facilitator.
Hi, I'm Sheila Ryder. I'm a member of the Stoneham Human Rights Commission, and I'm a book group facilitator.
Hi, I'm Kyle Rundles. I'm part of the Stoneham Reads Planning Committee and a book group facilitator.
Hi, I'm Maureen Saltzman, a librarian at the Stoneham Public Library and a book group facilitator.
Hi, I'm Debbie Sullivan. I'm on the Planning Committee and I'm owner of the Book Oasis.
Hi, I'm Alejandra Williamson, and I'm Spanish interpreter for the book groups.
Hello. My name is Ben Jacques. I'm a former teacher and an author, and I'm very happy to be a part of the Stoneham Reads program, and I'd like to invite you to join us in the upcoming discussion groups.
Hi, I'm Carlene Prince Erickson, a longtime Stoneham resident and one of the facilitators for the upcoming book discussions on Stamped, Racism, Antiracism, and You. While we all have different life experiences and opinions when it comes to the topic of race, I think at the end of the day, we can all agree that each of us wants to be seen, heard, and valued for who we are as people. I decided to get involved with Stoneham Reads after hearing that students would be reading the book in school. I thought Stoneham Reads offered a great opportunity to continue the conversation students were having in the classroom out in the community where there could be a full exchange of ideas. I hope you'll agree and consider joining us at one of the book discussion groups. I hope to see you there.
Hi everyone, my name is Rob Berkovich and I'm with Stoneham Bank and a book facilitator for Stoneham Reads. I think this is a great opportunity and hope you will join us for some sessions.
Stoneham Reads grew out of the Stoneham Public Schools Committee Subcommittee on Dismantling Structural Racism, with the desire to bring the conversation about racism to the larger community, Stoneham Reads was born as an ongoing reading program for the community to gather, share books, and discuss their themes.
For the book groups this spring, our book focuses on United States racial history and social justice. It is titled Stamped, Racism, Anti-Racism, and You by Jason Reynolds and Ibram X. Kendi. We believe by joining together to read, talk, and learn, we can make Stoneham a better place for all to live.
Registration is now live. The book groups are meeting mid-May to mid-June. You may sign up for a book group to discuss Stamped by going to stonehamcdc.org and clicking on the Register Now link.
The book Stamped is available in book form and in audio through loan at the Stoneham Public Library or for purchase at the Book Oasis in Stoneham. For more information, please visit the website, our website, The Book Oasis, at thebookoasis.com, or reserve your copy of Stamped through the Stoneham Public Library's NobleNet Library System at noblenet.org.
What will the book group be like? Book groups will be virtual, online, with up to 10 people. You'll be able to choose book groups that meet only one time or book groups that meet twice. You will have a range of dates and times to choose from.
Each book group will have two facilitators. All facilitators have received training in how to have conversations across race and intersectionality. We seek to make these groups welcoming and accessible to all.
Please let us know what barriers you face to participate. For example, our webpage is not yet screen reader friendly. So if, for that reason or for any other reason, you have difficulty learning about the project or registering, please email us at stonehamreads@stonehamcdc.org and we'll be in touch. Here's what we have prepared for access already. There will be large print, English, Spanish, and audio CD versions of the book available to borrow or to buy. We have a limited number of free books for people who are 65 and older, for young adults, and for anyone with financial need who would like to keep their copy. We can deliver a book to you if you would have trouble getting to the Book Oasis or Stoneham Library. For deaf and hard of hearing who prefer communication through an ASL interpreter, we're securing it for one or more groups. And anyone who will be able to use live captions that will print on your screen in English, and by signing up in advance, we can also provide live captions in Spanish.
Hello and welcome to Stoneham Reads. We would like to support you. Let us know what you need. If you speak Spanish and would like to participate in this project, I will be interpreting for at least one book group. A Spanish language version of the book is available for you at the library and at the Book Oasis. And if you're hard of hearing, live captions in Spanish are available too. Just let us know what you need and join us. Hola y bienvenidos a Stoneham Reads. Queremos apoyarlos, así que por favor cuéntenos qué necesitan. Si usted habla español y le gustaría participar en este proyecto, yo seré intérprete de al menos un grupo de discusión literaria. Una versión en español del libro se encuentra disponible en la biblioteca y en la librería local de Book Oasis. Si tiene alguna dificultad auditiva, también hay subtítulos en vivo disponibles en español. Los invitamos a participar.
You can register for book groups today. Go to the Stoneham CDC website at stonehamcdc.org and click on Register Now.
Hello, my name is Elise Rubin. And I teach U.S. History at Stoneham High School. This year, Stoneham High School is piloting the use of STAMP, Racism, Anti-Racism, and You, in several classrooms across multiple grades. I find STAMP to be an integral part of our curriculum. Through the author's approachable writing style, students have been able to access a more diverse view of our nation's history. To kick off Black History Month, I wanted my classes to engage with STAMP beyond just reading and answering questions. The activity I designed ask students to read a chapter on Phyllis Wheatley, the first Black woman to be published in the United States. Wheatley was also an enslaved person. Students incorporated the content they learned from the chapter into a creation of their own. Students merged a poem from Wheatley, His Excellency General Washington, with Amanda Gorman's now famous inaugural poem, The Hill He Climbed. By playing on the remixed writing style of author Jason Reynolds, these poems showcase the beautiful poetry put forth by Black women across American history. Enjoy.
Hi, my name is Katrina Casares from Stoneham High School, and today I'm going to be reading my remixed poem of Amanda Gorman and Phyllis Wheatley. This is from our stamped unit, which I'm learning in my history class right now, and I think it is a great book because I really like the way that the author speaks to the reader, and I like how it teaches us about racism.
I'm Sahil Rana, and today I'm reading a remixed poem from Amanda Gorman and Phyllis Wheatley. And in history class, we're reading this book called Stamped. It's a nice book. It's funny. It teaches me about the history of slavery and racism.
Siesta choir, enthroned thrones of light in this never-ending shade. See the bright beams of heaven's revolving light in a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. Unnumbered charms and recent graces rise. And so we lift our gazes to not what stands between us, but what stands before us.
Enough thou knowest them in the fields of fight. Thee, first in peace and honors we demand, the grace and glory of thy martial band. While freedom's cause her anxious breast alarms, she flashes dreadful, relightful arms. Somehow we do it.
Anon Britannica drops the pensive head, while round increase the rising hills of dead. See Mother Earth her offspring's fate bemoan, and nations gaze at scenes before the unknown.
See the bright beams of heaven's revolving light, involved in sorrows and the veil of night. We will rise from the golden hills of the west. We will rise from the wind-swept northeast, where our forefathers first realized revolution. Thy every action let the goddess guide, a crown, a mansion, and a throne that shine. With gold unfading, Washington be thine.
We seek harm to none and harmony for all. It's because being American is more than a pride we inherit. A muse, rope of virtuous world by pen relates, how our earth armies through a thousand gates, for there is always laid a crown, a mansion, a throne that shine. If only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to keep it.
Hello, everyone. My name is Rainey Parker, and I am a current member of the Stoneham Select Board. I would just like to start by thanking the Stoneham Reads Book Club and the Stoneham CDC for hosting this community reads event with the book Stamped, Racism, Antiracism, and You. Being the first African-American female to the Board of Selectmen has been an honor, and as well as a challenge. The discussions that are happening are good, they're positive, and the support from the community has been wonderful. I hope we stay on that trajectory. With the introduction of the Human Rights Commission, social justice groups all over town, I believe that Stoneham will be placed in a better light and more understanding with each other, community members. I would just like to say, moving forward, I hope that by doing these little things throughout town, we can all get around racial and ethnic harmony instead of the inequities. I believe that we are better together, and I hope that this opens doors for people to have conversations, real conversations, in your homes. If you have any questions for me, you can feel free to reach out. I appreciate everybody being involved in this project and look forward to the conversations. Thank you so much for joining.
My name is Shelley McNeil, and I'm a member of the Stoneham Select Board. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Stoneham CDC and Stoneham Reads for this opportunity to discuss racism and dismantling racism here in our community. In 2019, as a member of the Select Board, I was able to support the creation of a Human Rights Commission. This was an important first step to creating opportunities to address these kinds of issues here in Stoneham. As a member of the Stoneham Coalition for a Safe and Healthy Community, we often discuss race, especially in the matters of health disparities. I think any time that we can take the opportunity to discuss these issues that affect us all, I think it's important. to maintain open dialogue and open discussion. Racism impacts every aspect of our lives, and it's really important that we take every chance we can to get to know one another, to break down barriers, and to create better open lines of communication so that we can maintain a more inclusive community for all. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Nicole Langley, and I'm the director of the Stoneham Public Library. Here at the library, we are excited to support the Stoneham Reads program. You may know that the library is a part of the North of Boston Library Exchange, or NOBLE, network. Within the NOBLE system, there are many copies of Stamped, Racism, Anti-Racism, and You. There are many copies of the physical book throughout the system, as well as audio CDs, ebooks, and even a copy in large print. Call us here at the library if you need assistance in getting one of these copies. The phone number is 781-438-1324. If you are familiar with the NOBLE system, go to the online catalog at noblenet.org and search to reserve a copy for yourself. Again, call the library at 781-438-1324 or go to noblenet.org to reserve your copy today. Thank you, and we look forward to seeing you soon.
See you in the book group.